So, my friend Kimber asked me last night, how long does it take to make a great cup of coffee, start to finish? And I said, I don't know, but I'll find out. So, we're going to start with the usual suspects, a pump-driven espresso machine, burr coffee grinder, some ice, some fresh milk, fresh cream, and vanilla syrup. So we've ground our beans, move our unit from our head unit, then we're gonna scoop some in there. And there are several types of scoopers and lots of theories on tamping coffee. The truth is, in my world, very cheap plastic scoop, and there's no need to tamp because this machine has a pressurized portafilter. Most do. So you just want to get them even in there, right? Put it into your head unit. Position your shot glass. We're doing a double shot, by the way. And that, my friend, is what a proper shot of espresso looks like. We've got three parts. And we're going to put this over ice. They put about twice that much in your $7 drink. An alley-oop. Now, for the purist, we'll make just like a regular espresso, right? We're gonna have to steam milk on this one. No big deal. Steam your milk ahead of time, you'll have a lot better chance of having a piping hot cup of coffee. And that's what we're going to do. Steaming milk is really just injecting super hot air into your milk. Being careful not to scald it. So with the steaming wand in a pump-driven machine, you have to switch it from steam to pump and then prime the pump. it's critical. Running a pump dry can cause that pump to fail. So all we're waiting on is the green light from our pump saying that it's hot enough, and there it is. Now we used a shot glass earlier, but we're gonna just do Matisse cups. Making a good coffee drink is messy. Don't let anybody tell you anything different. Use a spoon to hold some of that froth back because we want it to be sort of our crowning glory. And you can even finish it up a little bit. I don't know if you can even see this. Anyway, happy brewing.